Well, as cautious as we need to be about reporting poll figures, the dire state of affairs for the federal government has become a story in itself, with a fresh news poll due out shortly, probably 15 minutes away, I think. There are also some intriguing trends about how we're willing to vote this year and the sacrifices that we might be willing to make. Political editor Hugh Riminton, unusually, is in the studio with us tonight. Very privileged to have you here. I think I'm right in saying it's about 15 minutes away before we see the news poll figures. It's not going to be anything better than what it has been in the last few weeks.
I'm told it won't be any better. The news poll, as you say, not quite out yet. Don't have those numbers. I'm told there's no major change reflected in the new news poll. It'll be published in the paper tomorrow, the Australian newspaper tomorrow, and online, I think, later tonight. But no change is still bad news, obviously, for the Labor government, because it is caught in a death zone. We know that. We'll be waiting around to see if any polls change that narrative. Yeah. But, you know, there's in many ways, a more interesting poll came out today, which dug in a little bit, unpacked a little some of the contradictions which are existing at the moment in Australia in the strangest of election years. It's from the Essential Research Group, and here's what it found.
Like other pollsters, Essential has Labor behind, a 12-point spread, 56 to 44, in the coalition's favour. But they also asked whether people think things will be better or worse under a Tony Abbott-led government. Now, out of 15 measures, on only two is Tony Abbott clearly ahead. A net 25% of respondents think company profits will be better under the coalition. A narrower 10% think the overall economy will be better. The other 13 measures are either a statistical tie or people think they'll be worse off. So people think conditions in the workplace will be worse, the environment, interest rates will be higher, job security will be lower, public services will be diminished, almost all across the board, health, the cost of living, personal finances, unemployment. On those measures in this poll, by a significant margin, people think things will be worse under Tony Abbott. Yet they're still getting ready to vote for him.
So how is that? We think Tony Abbott's going to be bad for us, but we're going to vote for him anyway. This is your work, Peter Lewis, from Essential. You came up with this. How do you explain the inherent contradiction in those numbers?
We're a bit like that mountain climber who got his arm stuck in the rock and then had to cut his own arm off with a penknife, aren't we? Look, I think at this stage of the electoral cycle, there's a really strong protest vote against the Labor government that came out in our questions today too. 57% say they don't deserve to be re-elected. But this question about how will life be different if there is a change of government hasn't really been asked before. And as your report showed, on a lot of the key indicators that actually drive people's votes, everything from interest rates, cost of living, down to the provision of health and public services, workers' rights and protection for the disabled and pensioners, they think it's actually going to be worse.
Now that flies in the face of almost every truism of politics, and that is that people ultimately will vote for their self-interest. And even though a Tony Abbott-led coalition government is supposed to be better overall by the economy. Mm. In the economy that matters to people, will your job be safer? Will unemployment be better or worse? Will interest rates go up or down? Tony Abbott is seen as worse. Could people be about to vote against their perceived self-interest?
I suspect we're still in the first phase of an election campaign. It's a very lengthened campaign, but you normally start a campaign with people in the mood of a protest vote, and then the job of the government and the incumbent is actually to prove to people that there's going to be a risk in that. Now, we found out today also only 36% of people believe the Liberals are ready to govern. If you put that finding in line with these findings on attitudes to how their life will change, I wouldn't say it's a magic bullet or a silver bullet for Labor, but there is a glimmer of hope that there is a series of questions that you can ask people where they haven't conclusively said we're over this government.
Is another way to read this, that the psychodrama, if you like, of the Gillard-Rudd event has become such a burden, people just want to jettison it no matter what the outcome?
Oh, look, absolutely. When you're talking about yourself, you're not talking about those issues that were highlighted in the poll findings, which is actually the translation of politics to people's lives. Good politicians break down the barrier of the soap opera and actually let people focus on the things that matter.
Peter, is it fair to say, you pointed out that we're at a particular point in the election campaign, actually we're a very long way out from the real campaign. Is it fair to say that part of the reason people are saying they think on these key issues they'll be worse off under Abbott is that they simply don't know, because so few of their actual policies have been fleshed out?
Yeah, look, I think this is probably the first time a lot of people are asked to reflect on that. But then I guess opening up that question is part of the political conversation that the government will want to be having this year.
Mm. All right. Well, thank you very much for coming in tonight, Peter Lewis. I think you're going to hang around, Hugh.
I might do. to the end of the show. Why not?
We,
I've got a bedtime bite for you.
Yeah, we're so happy to have you here.